Good morning, everyone. How is everyone? How was the day? I know it's very difficult to be at home, especially in student life. But the times are tough. We have to be safe. We have to stay informed. We have to stay healthy. And we are in our homes for good cause, to keep ourselves healthy and to keep our family healthy. So stay at home, stay healthy, stay informed, and we shall keep joining for the online classes till we have defeated this virus, Corona. Now, coming on to today's topic, we take up resources and development we shall be taking today. First, let's define resources. What is a resource? What do you call a resource? See, everything in the environment that fulfills our need, provided it is technologically accessible, economically feasible, and culturally acceptable, can be termed as a resource. Types of resources. See, we can classify them on the basis of origin. We can also classify them on the basis of accessibility. We can classify them on the basis of ownership. And we can also classify them on the basis of their status and development. Let's take them one by one. First, talking about classification of resources on the basis of origin, they can be classified as biotic and abiotic. Biotic and abiotic. See, all those resources which are obtained from the biosphere can be termed as biotic. They have life. And all those resources which are obtained from non-living things can be termed as abiotic. Talking about classification of resources on the basis of accessibility, we can term them renewable and non-renewable. When we say renewable, all those resources which can be renewed by any process, it may be a physical process, it may be a chemical process, it may be a mechanical process, by any process, if we can renew them, we call them renewable resources. And if the resources occur over millions of years, if they take a long time, those resources can be termed as non-renewable resources. When we talk about the classification of resources on the basis of their ownership, they can be put into four categories. Those are individual resources, community resources, national and international. Talking about those individual resources, see, you must have seen in your village, there are people who own land. There are people who own things. So, all those resources which are owned by individuals are called individual resources. They are privately owned by the individuals. Talking about the community resources, all those resources which are owned by a community. Say for example, the park where children play, the parks, the playgrounds, the land where all the animals of the village graze, the grazing grounds, all those lands are, they are community owned. They are not owned by individuals. And when we talk about natural resources, students, legally speaking, everything legally is owned by the nation. Even your private properties, your individual properties can be taken by the nation if they are required. You must have seen for building roads, for building schools and hospitals, government acquire land. So those lands are acquired by the government because everything is considered a national owned resource. Then we talk about the international resources. Before we go on to the international resources, let me tell you, even the resources which are in the waters, in the oceans, up to 12 nautical miles are national. They are owned by a particular nation. Beyond that, of course, they are not owned by any nation, they are international. So there are waters, there are oceans which are not owned by any nation. There are resources which are not owned by any nation, and all such resources are known as international resources. Talking about the resources based on their status or development. The resources based on their status or development. The first in that category can be potential resource. Potential resources are those resources which have the potential to be used, which are not being used right now. Right now, we are unable to use them, but they can be used on a later stage. When we talk about the developed resources are those resources which have been surveyed, their quality and quantity have been surveyed, that their quality has been determined for utilization, and we can use them as and when required. When we talk about the stock resources have the potential to satisfy human needs, but they are technologically, they are not accessible right on date. So they have the potential, but technologically we will have to improve our technology to use the stock resources. And when we talk about the reserves, reserves are the subset of the stock resources. They are a part of the stock resources. Reserve resources, see, for example, when we say that water is a compound of two things, that is hydrogen and oxygen. And hydrogen has got great potential to be used as fuel. But right now, we do not have the technology to, we do not have the know-how to use hydrogen as a fuel. So, as of today, it is a stock resource. But the same water, when we talk about generating hydroelectric power, we have the know-how. So the same water becomes a reserve resource. Because we know the know-how, we can use it. Although we are not making the use to the fullest extent today, but as and when required, we can use it. So these were the classifications of resources. Do revise them, make note of them. Tomorrow you will be required to answer my questions, and then we shall take up the chapter further. Till then, it's goodbye from the desk. Stay fit, stay healthy, stay informed, and keep informing others. Thank you.